Verge of puking.
That sounds so bad to say. The lettuce.
Boss manager.
It's so messy.
Hey guys! Welcome back to another vlog. Here with Julia. We're doing a very fun video today.
I'm so excited.
We honestly are so excited. I watch these so much and we finally get to do it in real life and we thought it would be a fun video.
To literally let the person in front of us decide what we eat.
We don't even know what we're gonna get. Like, we're praying for some food. We're freaking hungry.
We're starving. I haven't eaten all day and it's 5:30 almost.
Yeah, but we have a few places on our list. We're just gonna go see what happens and we're gonna do a Q&A at the end slash like just a little chat slash mukbang, so make sure you stick around for that. The first place we are going to Starbucks, and we already got Starbucks this morning. So
round two, baby.
Yeah, I feel like Starbucks is like a good one to start with, you know.
Okay,
let's go. Make sure you guys give this video a big thumbs up right now. Also, comment down below if you guys have ever done this challenge before or if you guys ever wanted to. Comment down below.
I'm nervous. Don't be nervous.
I'm hoping for a cold drink. We currently have a red car in front of us. Oh my gosh, they're leaving. I'm hoping for a drink and a sandwich. Cold drink.
I'm good, how are you?
Wait, thank you. We're gonna get something.
Could I actually get whatever the person in front of me ordered, but can you not tell me what it is?
Okay. You want a surprise drink? Okay, I got you.
Yeah, so whatever they got.
Whatever size as well?
Yes.
Okay, I got you.
Okay, thank you so much.
Honestly, it's like a guy
driving a red Santa Fe
Hyundai.
I'm getting like his like girlfriend or something is in the front seat and she's like, oh, I'll get this crazy order. And he's like, oh, I'll get some like frap of some sort. You know what I'm saying?
For real.
Why he kind of...
No, but it's literally like 27 degrees. It was 30 earlier, so it's really hot. So I don't think we could deal with hot drinks.
Anticipation.
Get your stars, people.
I'm really far away.
Hi.
Hello.
Do you want to say hi? We're filming a video.
Oh, yeah.
So sweet.
Oh, wait, I thought there was two.
Yeah, me too.
Wait, I feel like it's a passion tea lemonade.
Okay, so this was the drink. It looks pretty.
It's venti.
It's a venti passion tea lemonade, add strawberry base, 7 pumps of liquid cane syrup.
Seven pumps?
When I get my regular Starbucks order, I get 1 pump of the syrup.
Okay, wait, passion tea lemonades?
Yeah.
Are like my childhood drink. Like
really?
That's what I would get. Like I didn't know what to get at Starbucks. I didn't even know Starbucks was a thing. So I feel like it's gonna send me back.
We're gonna try this. It better not, it's gonna be really sweet.
Sweet.
Very sugary.
Very. I just put it everywhere.
It's good though. I don't like refreshers and that's good.
That's really good.
I don't know. I'll give it like a 7 out of 10.
I miss that drink.
It's different. Mm. It's something I definitely wouldn't have gotten.
Yeah.
What's your rating?
Honestly, it's a classic. So like a 7.
Yeah, that's what I did too. First one wasn't bad. That wasn't bad. But we're really hoping for some food.
Yes.
So hopefully the next one will give us some food.
A Tesla in front of us this time.
Oh. What do you think?
I think he is gonna get a classic, basic, disgusting coffee. If I'm being honest.
I really hope not. What if he gets like a large ice cap?
I wouldn't be too mad actually.
But we really just want some food. Like, food is a must.
We're definitely gonna get food at like McDonald's and like that. And
100%.
And
yeah.
Panera.
Ugh. Yeah.
I'm so excited for Panera.
Hi,
is there any way I could get the same thing the person in front of me ordered, but can you not tell me what it is?
Yeah.
Thank you.
Was that a B, Julia? I'm sorry. I really hope it's not a drink.
I know, me too. They're hot.
Mm-hmm.
What the f*** are these?
They're like hot.
There's a D on it.
They're double doubles. This one was a fail, guys.
Not double doubles.
I hate hot coffee, so.
Cheers.
Cheers. It just tastes like milk.
It's just boring.
Look how light that is. There's so much milk in this and cream.
As people who live in Canada, I feel like we should be like, oh my God, Timmy's. But like, no, this is not what you go and get at Timmy's. Mm-hmm. Like you get an ice cap or donuts.
It's 27 degrees. Who drinks hot coffee in 27 degree weather?
Yeah,
no. Yeah, honestly, I don't even know what to do with this.
Chaser.
For real. But anyways, we just got to Panera, so we better get some food because we're getting hangry.
Yeah.
So there's a black Hyundai. They already ordered. We're right up next. I'm really hoping for mac and cheese. Really bad.
Hi there, what can I get for you?
Hi, how are you?
I'm good, thanks. How are you?
Good, thank you. Is there any way I could get the same person, the person in front of me, or the same... Sorry, the same thing the person in front of me got, but just like, don't tell me what it is.
You are the first person to ever do that.
Yeah, we're filming a video, so we're just,
yeah,
you know.
We're not gonna tell you what it is.
Okay, thank you so much. I know, I'm so excited. Is it good?
It's a good way to try new things you've never tried before.
Oh, yeah, perfect. 100%.
I've seen other people do that on YouTube.
Oh my gosh.
Thank you. You as well.
We got food, guys. Oh my god. Oh, there's a cookie, I think. Okay, what's the sandwich? That looks so good right now.
Guys,
that's so needed. Oh, she did add the cookie.
That's,
I think,
so cute. Yeah, it doesn't say it.
She gave us a free cookie. She is the sweetest drive-through worker I've ever freaking seen.
Oh my god, smell it.
It's gonna be so good. And then this is the salad.
That actually doesn't look that bad.
It doesn't. Oh, there's another thing.
Bread, probably.
Yeah,
the bread.
I love Panera Bread's bread. Oh, so freaking good. I'm disappointed that we didn't get mac and cheese though.
Me too, but we can always come back.
What should we try first? Sandwich? Yeah, okay. It has bacon, turkey, cheese, mayo, I'm assuming.
How's it? Is it good? Yeah.
That is so good. Mmm. That is like so good. It's just like a basic sandwich, but it's so good. I'm easily giving that like 8.5 out of 10.
Mm-hmm.
It's so basic, but...
I was gonna say the same thing.
Maybe we're just really hungry. Oh wait, what was your rating?
8.5.
Time for the cookie. I've never had this cookie. It's huge, guys. It's like the size of our faces.
Mm-hmm. It's giving Tim's cookie, but it's good. That was like a peanut butter cookie.
Mm-hmm. It's really sweet.
What was your rating?
Like a 6.
Yeah, nothing special.
Cookie. Yeah.
I'll give that out of 5. Some of their other cookies are a lot better. Okay, now I'm really nervous for this. I hate red onions. I'm nervous for these red onions. Is there chicken in it?
Mm, yeah.
Oh, slay. Regular salad?
It's just a salad.
It's funny because Panera has like some really like crazy salads. So I'm interested to try just like a plain one. I'm still just disappointed in the mac and cheese. I really want a mac and cheese.
Those onions are actually really good.
Really?
Not bad. It's just a salad, you know?
Mm-hmm. Would you rate this one?
Like a 7.
7?
Yeah, 7.5.
Yeah, I'll stick with a 7 too. It's very average, but very delish. On to the next spot. We're at Arby's. There's a red Kia in front of us. It's only one lady, it looks like. Hopefully she orders some curly fries.
Order some food for her family.
She seems like the girl that could get curly fries.
Hi, could I possibly get what the person in front of me ordered, but can you not tell me what it is?
She's thinking.
Hello?
Yeah.
Is that okay?
Yeah.
Okay, thank you. Bye.
What just happened?
Oh, okay.
Ooh, a Coke.
Ooh, I hate pop.
Thank you.
Ooh. Arby's review. So I've never actually had anything else from Arby's other than their curly
fries. A double beef and cheddar? Oh, wow.
It's huge.
Wow, that looks really f-ing good. Look at it.
Okay, so that's a double beef and cheddar.
That's good. Okay. I think this is turkey Swiss. Whoa.
I feel like I'll really like that.
Ooh.
It's like a grilled cheese.
So that's the turkey Swiss. Yum.
Ooh.
I want that one. I'm so sorry. I have to.
Yeah, do it.
Cheers.
Mmm. I haven't had Arby's fries in so long.
Oh my god. Yum.
11 out of 10. I don't even have to think about it.
Okay.
What's your rating?
Honestly, like a good... If they were warmer...
Oh, yeah.
But I would say they're like a good, like, 8.
Next. This thing is massive.
Looks pretty good, though. I can't lie.
I'm, like, nervous.
And
it's
just
dripping everywhere.
Made the same mess I started with. Cheers. Cheers.
Maybe it needs another bite.
Yeah.
It's okay. I feel like I couldn't eat, like, a whole thing of that, though. A few bites is good for me.
Yeah. Honestly, I'm gonna give it like an 8.5. I liked it.
Wow, that's surprising.
Yeah, it's pretty good.
I think I'm gonna settle with like a 5.5.
Oh, wow.
And lastly, I'm excited for this one.
Tomato energy.
Tomato, onion, turkey. Is that mayo or like tartar sauce?
Mayo.
I feel like I'm gonna like this though.
Cheers. Cheers.
It's like overload mayo. Yeah, I'm not a fan.
Not loving it.
Not loving it.
Not McLovin.
The onions are so big. Like, I can just taste onion in my mouth. and mayo.
Yeah.
Mayo and onion.
Sorry, what do you give that one?
Honestly, like a 3.
I'm gonna say like a,
like I, my breath stinks like onion.
It's coming back up. Yeah, I'm gonna give it a 3 too. Honestly.
Like this one was better. This like greasy thing going on.
I mean, it looks horrible, but yeah. It was pretty good.
McDonald's. It's a white car. I don't know how many people are in it.
Is there any way I could order the same thing that the person in front of me ordered, but can you not tell me what it is?
Sorry?
Is there any way I can order what the person in front of me ordered, but can you not tell me what it is?
One second.
You want to order something, but you don't want to know what you want to order?
Hi.
Is the chicken nuggets?
No, so...
Alright,
it's $28.85. Okay.
Yep.
Oh, that's a lot of food.
That is a lot of food for McDonald's.
Thank you.
Oh my god, there's drinks.
Thank you.
Oh, my god, there's coffee.
Wait, that's really...
Is that your guys'?
I don't think so. It was just put in, so maybe not.
Wait, is it 6 nuggets to double treat?
No.
Yeah, oh my bad. I just gave you guys the whole...
It was like a $20.85 or something.
We almost just f***ed up everything, bro.
Thank you. That's okay, you too.
McDonald's was our last stop. We don't even know what's in here.
We don't even know what that drink is.
Oh, yeah, you're gonna have to taste that. I don't drink pop, guys, and I also don't eat burgers. We don't know what this one is.
Should I smell it? Smells like another Coke.
Really? No. No. It's all in my purse.
No, G. I'm so sorry. The bad luck has started again.
It's okay, we saved a lot. It barely got on me. BRB.
Bye. Anyways, sorry about that, guys.
Back to the video.
Can I try this drink now?
Yeah, you should try half of it.
It's a Coke.
We got $20 worth of McDonald's. Who knows what could be in here?
We haven't seen it yet.
No, we haven't.
Truthfully.
There's lots of burgers.
Ah, there's nuggets.
Oh, really?
Okay, so there's fries. Medium fry.
That's a winner.
Double cheeseburger. Junior chicken. Okay, you can eat that. And 6 McNuggets. And some sweet and sour sauce at the bottom. And some extra fries that I'm gonna eat right now.
Of course. I don't eat burgers, guys. Fun fact, so.
You might like the chicken burger.
Yeah, I'll try the junior chicken for sure.
Ooh, quality, period. Ooh, cheersies.
Cheers.
Mm-hmm.
I've never had a junior chicken burger thing, sandwich. It's actually pretty good.
Mine's good.
I give that like a solid like 7.5.
Yum.
What's your rating for your burger?
Freaking like 8.5. I have these.
It's involved. Yeah, it's McDonald's. Fries. I don't even think we have to rate these ones.
I really don't.
A little cold.
Yeah.
Honestly, 9 out of 10.
8 fries.
You can never go wrong with McDonald's fries.
We got our chicken nuggies.
I haven't had chicken nuggets from McDonald's in so f***ing long.
Cheersies.
I remember why I haven't eaten these.
A little plasticky.
A little rubbery.
We both take another f***ing bite.
I needed a second opinion.
What? What the f*** is that?
I don't know.
That?
Yeah, I think so. 1 out of 10. And that is me being generous. Never again. That is our little food
review.
Now we're actually gonna eat instead of just taste everything.
And now we are going to answer your questions that you guys asked us on our Instagram stories.
And also my YouTube community tab page, which make sure you guys always check that page. I always post constant updates like every day. And also follow us both on Instagram. It'll be at the top of the screen.
Perfect.
Let's get into the questions and let's eat. Literally the most commonly asked question was, how did Julie and I meet? How long have we been friends? When do we start becoming friends? Everything like that. So honestly, we met in elementary school because we went to the same elementary school. We knew each other for a few years, but we didn't start getting close till what? Like,
I would say like 2019, like so grade 8.
Yeah.
Like at the very end of grade 8.
I remember the grade 8 grad trip when we went to Blue Mountain. We like were best friends. Like we like hung out the whole
trip. We didn't room together though.
No, we didn't. Because our rooms had to be picked before we were really like close. Mm-hmm. But yeah, that's basically how we met. And then we've been really close, like, and stayed in touch ever since.
Grade 9 was a little rocky for us. We had a little bit of a fight.
Yeah, and here we are today. That's to answer your guys' question. That was the most commonly asked one, to be honest.
Yeah. Yeehaw, says Hayden Cowan. Okay, well, I'm gonna ask you this question. Would your younger self think you're pretty if she walked by you?
I don't know. Maybe me, like, a few years ago, yes. But me now, no.
I think my younger self would be so damn confused. When they look at me, they'd be like, who is that? Because I'm so different than when I was a kid. Like, yeah, I just looked too. Nothing like I did when I was a kid.
That's a good question. I like that question.
Me too. Shout out to Jill Story.
Okay, next question says, what or who got you into YouTube and why did you choose to do a channel about books? Love all your videos, XX. I love her. She's the biggest sweetheart, but I don't really know who got me into YouTube. I know it was kind of my dad's idea and I just started doing it as a joke, but now obviously things have changed, but there wasn't really a reason. I think I just really loved books and that's what I wanted to start with. And then I branched out towards vlogs and stuff and I fell in love with filming those and like kind of coming up with so many creative ideas. So I think that's kind of the main thing.
I would have never thought you'd start YouTube.
Me neither. Like honestly,
like
me personally, yeah. And then one connecting that is, how do you edit and do like your thumbnails and all that? I did mention this in my What's on My iPhone video about my thumbnails. I use 3 apps. I'll put them up on the screen. That's how I do my thumbnails. And then editing, I use Final Cut Pro and I honestly love it. It was so easy to learn and I honestly taught myself completely from start to finish how to edit my videos that I post for you guys. It was a lot of learning.
Watch her edit every single freaking time I'm
over.
She
would know.
And I still don't get it. Like literally at all. Like I have no idea. Like I find it so fascinating how good she is at editing because there are so many things on that whatever you use. I couldn't even, like I don't even know how to import the damn footage. Like, I have no idea. Like, this girl is amazing.
Thanks, Joe.
Connor says, who do you look up to and what about them inspires you? I've always said this. My cousin, Sophia, I've always looked up to her. She was like my sister growing up. Like, literally, we're so close and we still are so close. And I think like everything that I do now, like has a small part what I watched her do. So I don't know. I just think she's awesome.
I love Sophia. She's the sweetest human being ever. But
agreed. Well, not agreed. Love you, girl. But you're
I think if I was to base it off celebrities, I would say Alyssa Howard.
Oh, that's not what I thought you were going to say at all.
Really? She inspired me to start doing vlogs and I just have fallen in love with her videos. Like she's literally my idol. I don't really have that big of an explanation. If it was like personally, it would definitely be like my mom and my dad for sure. They've taught definitely. Me so much just about life, me being like who I am today. 100% though.
I was going to say that too. I was going to say like my mom.
Yeah. Love that. That was a cute question.
Love our parents. Yeah. Thanks, Connor. That was a good question. Do you like the city better or do you like the country better?
City. It used to be country. Now it's city.
See, I think I'm a country girl.
Yeah. 100%.
Like, I love the cottage. Like, if I had all my friends in the country with me, I'd be freaking thriving. Like, I love
that's
that.
True.
You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm. Okay, so actually said, social security number.
Five? No. Unfortunately, it's illegal.
So. Oh, this is a good one. What is your go-to Starbucks order? They already know mine, probably.
Grande, iced, brown sugar, shaken espresso with one pump of brown sugar and light ice.
Yes!
That was very nerve-wracking.
Julia's is a grande iced caramel macchiato. Someone asked, how many books do I own? And to actually count them.
This is nuts.
Yeah, so I did see this question and I counted before we left and I own 147 books currently.
Same.
Yeah.
Twinsies.
I don't really know how to read. But yeah, it's kind of becoming a problem, but I've slowed down on my book buying addiction. We're working on it. It's like a work in progress.
I'm gonna kind of relate this to us because we want to do this together.
Okay.
So if you could go anywhere, like travel anywhere in the world, where would you choose to go and why?
We are planning on traveling together after I get back from my big trip. I don't know. Together, we were looking at a bunch of different spots. We're kind of open, I feel like. Mm-hmm. But definitely like somewhere like tropical and somewhere we've always wanted to like go. I don't know. We were looking in Greece.
We looked at Hawaii for a bit, but we want everything mm-hmm. to be the safest it possibly can.
Yeah.
So yeah, something like that probably.
Yeah. I'm honestly open. I'm going to Greece. So I feel like if it's really, really, really good, then I would want to bring us to Greece. But then again, we might want to go somewhere we both have never been, which would be like Hawaii or something.
Yeah.
And we've always wanted to go to Hawaii.
Want to live that Hannah Meloche life. So bad.
For real.
So bad. But yeah, I agree. I think somewhere we just haven't been, somewhere we want to explore.
I agree 100%.
Jill wants to know, ugliest fashion trend.
Oh, there's a I don't even think I could narrow it down to one. What was recent?
I'm gonna get so flamed for this. Foam runners are the ugliest things I've ever seen in my entire
life. Oh my God, me too.
Like, I agree. Looks like a block of Swiss cheese. I can't do it.
I agree. No, honestly, I don't even care.
Like, I've always said that. Ugly. They're so yeah. awful.
Ever since those came out, I was like, why are we buying these?
I just don't get it. Like, okay, yeah, they're trendy because they think that like other people think they're nice too, but be so for real, everyone thinks they're hideous.
Yeah,
people just want the clout.
And like, how do you even wear them? You can see your toes if you don't wear socks, but if you wear them with socks they just look even more silly. I don't know, like, how do you even wear them? How do you style them?
Leave some comments below.
Yeah. Let us know what your thoughts are
on how to freaking style foam runners. God.
Another question, it's sort of related to content and stuff like that. It says, could you make a section about content creation and maybe sprinkle in some tips. I really want to start my own BookTube channel. Honestly, I put a lot of thought towards this question the last Q&A that I did when I hit 1,000 subscribers. That literally feels not that long ago. Honestly, my biggest tips for you are, number one, consistency. If you don't have consistency, it's just like, it's not going to go anywhere. And that was something that I learned because I wanted it so bad. I wanted to become monetized so bad and reach my goals that I kept pushing and pushing and pushing and stayed consistent. And it honestly works. It shows. And to help with that, honestly, just create a schedule. Create the days that you're going to film. Create the days that you're going to have time to edit. And then also, I recommend a posting schedule. It kind of helps with the YouTube algorithm a little bit. And it also just kind of keeps you on a schedule. So then you can kind of go into a routine, if that makes sense. Consistency, dedication, and patience are the three main words that I could give you for kind of like tips, if that makes sense. That's what I've learned, at least. Everyone's obviously different. And also, just start it. Like, you never know until you start. And yes, your first video will probably not be that good.
Trial and error, though.
Yeah.
Trial and error. Keep that in mind.
100%. Just start. You have to start somewhere. Put yourself out there and just post a video. If it doesn't get views, it doesn't get views. Just keep trying to improve something every single video you make, if that makes sense. There's your little YouTuber advice. But if you guys want a full video, like kind of explaining a little bit more about like my YouTube journey, how I create things, how I've succeeded and stuff so far, let me know down below, because I would love to make a whole video on it, because I have so much information and so much more advice I want to give you. But obviously I'm not gonna go into that in this video, but let me know down below. I think I went through all the questions I wanted to answer.
Biggest turn on. No.
Whoever gave us this question, it was a bad idea. Zenon asked, celebrity crush.
Mine's Drake, if anyone cared.
That's so vags.
I love that man.
He's in the After movies. If you guys have seen that like series of movies, it's the guy in it. I don't remember his name. I'll try to put a picture of him and his name. I just don't remember it, but I've always loved him as an actor. So if I had to choose, that's the first person that comes to mind, to be honest.
We have no more questions, but we didn't try any bread yet.
Oh my gosh, the bread.
And the cookie.
I have two sandwiches on my lap.
Oh wow. She's hard, isn't she?
Yummy bread.
Yummy bread.
It's actually really good though. Panera bread's delicious. It's getting pretty late. I think I'm pretty full. Are you pretty full?
Oh god.
Yeah.
I'm full.
We ate, but we needed it because we were so hungry. I really hope you guys enjoyed today's video. Something different. Let us know if you guys liked this video and if you guys want to see more of this style, because it was really fun.
Maybe a part two, possibly, with new places?
Yeah, for sure. Let us know down below.
Subscribe to G's channel right now. Make sure you like the video.
And also, don't forget to check the link in my description for my Patreon to join the Patreon family. But other than that, I hope you guys are having an amazing, wonderful day, and I'll see you next time. Bye! Maybe we, like, what should we
do? Do like a ew face.
You're like woke up like.
No, I swear to God, I woke up like this.
Why did just send me 10 cents?
What?
Thank you for the 10 cents. I'm just gonna blur your name.
Okay.
Oh my god, people are so fucking aggressive.
You fine. Anyways.
Anyways.
Go ahead. Ice. Go ahead, please.
Okay, why am I so verb? Okay, now, Gianna, rearrange that clip.
Oh, lighting fix. But I'll hit the curb. But do your best.
I'm sorry, what?
Maybe. Yeah.
Yeah, we're just gonna leave. Leave it at that.
Oops. Wow, she's thick, isn't she?
Bad drama. Oh,
why do you open your damn window?
Oh, yeah. Because when it's like. Oh, now it's like sunny. What is this lighting? Hi, editing Gianna. I'm sorry.
Hi, Gigi. Tastes like seat, so.
She's a plum sauce girly. We knew each other for a food. Hello? We both just. Seems too political.
Is this gonna die? Or no, what? No? Sorry. Run it back.
We were like. That looks soggy. Mac and cheese.